Greetings, groovy people. This is the self-proclaimed Blue Dragon, and I welcome you to this week's video, All Those Years Ago. This is part two of the quote-unquote Dark Horse Origins. Sounds so much more epic than it actually is. Dark Horse, for those of you just joining in, is my free, not safe for work webcomic, which can be viewed at the links down below in the description. This week's title is a reference to the George Harrison song All Those Years Ago, and that's what I'm gonna be delving into in this week's video while I am in the background screen toning an Act 4 revamp page. I've come to the realization that I may have to do a part 3 and maybe even a part 4, but you know, I'll cross that bridge when it comes. I'm probably gonna talk more about this later on. So the year is 1995, and I am 11 years old. I'm jamming to, you know, like, the Pulse and 90s music and Color Me Bad and Motown Philly, you know, that's the name of the song, but Boys to Men, stuff like that. I mean, I'm also starting to get into grunge music because of my sister. She loved STP, she loved Nirvana, all that. But music was, like, a really big part of my life and my family life, and, you know, I feel like this is kind of a common thread with so many people. I mean, music is just so very important and influential to us culturally. And we had a large living room with a record player, and we had a tape player, but later we eventually got a CD player, and the TV wasn't in the living room. The TV was on our back porch. So you could listen to music if you didn't want to watch whatever somebody was watching. When I was younger, I wouldn't have called myself a Beatle fan, but I certainly knew who the Beatles were because we listened to stuff like Peter, Paul, and Mary, John Denver, Pete Seeger, you know, folk music, some Bob Dylan, stuff like that. Mom let us, you know, listen to, like, Yellow Submarine, stuff of that nature. So I was aware, vaguely, who the Beatles were. It was like my parents' music. I will say that I was, however, from a very young age, a big fan of Ringo Starr. I digress. So it's 1995, and that's the year, towards the end of the year, there was this big television event where the Beatles anthology came out and was aired on TV. And it was basically everything you need to know about the Beatles, at least at the time. I mean, there's even more that you know about now, but at the time, this was like a big deal. Again, I said we shared a TV, so I probably watched a little bit of this, but to be honest, I wasn't really obsessed with the Beatles quite yet, but my cousin got wind of this, and because her dad was not at all a Beatle fan, he's like 6 years older than my mother, and her mom had, I think, a handful of Beatle albums, but mostly they had country music. She really wanted me to start listening to the Beatles, and we were, I mean, my older cousin, we were all really close, including my sister, all four of us. But the older kids were more into grunge because they were older. So she really, I gotta give her credit, she's the one who really got me listening to the Beatles. And my parents both loved the Beatles. So we had like two copies of just about every album. So she would come over and we would listen to albums together, or we would hang out and request Beatles songs from the local oldie station or something of that nature. We eventually, I don't think I ever got any tapes. Like, honestly, I think I always listened to the albums, but she bought or had her mom buy quite a few of the tapes. So I became super, super obsessed with the Beatles. The two of us did. So much so that it made both of our sisters kind of sick of the Beatles. Although I think my older cousin got bounced back a little sooner than my sister did. My sister still doesn't like the Beatles because I drove her mad with it. I really did. I almost made everyone sick of it. Okay, so by this point, you might be wondering, what in the hell has any of this got to do with Dark Horse? Well, I'm gonna get there. While listening to the Beatles, they had a lot of albums. They had 10 albums. But eventually, you know, you listen to all the albums and you are still left craving more. So we expanded to, like, their movies. We got the Beatlefest magazine because we were never going to get driven to St. Louis to go to Beatlefest. So we got the Beatlefest magazine, and since, you know, PBS didn't always show Beatles shows very often, sometimes they'd have A Hard Day's Night on, and sometimes they'd have help, we tried to order VHS of their movies. That's still not enough. We're trying to relive Beatlemania without having been there. So it's not enough. We got more Beatles. So eventually we expanded to the Beatles' solo career, which my mom, she had quite a few John albums, and her favorite Beatle, George Harrison, she had the All Things Must Pass album and a couple other of his albums. George Harrison, being mom's favorite, had a major influence on her teenage years. When she was younger, she, you know, got interested in Buddhism. Not so much Hinduism, but if you know anything about George Harrison, as far as I can tell, he converted to Hinduism. I mean, this was something that was truly a part of his faith. And that had, obviously, an impact on his music. And it also had an impact on a lot of the cover art that he had. And it had an impact, in a way, on my mom. Now, she never became Hindu, but she studied Buddhism. And I wanted to be just like my mom. Like, I even went vegetarian initially because I wanted to be like my mom and the Beatles, because three of the Beatles were vegetarian. I mean, later on, the whole thing became my own, and I cared more about the animal rights, and I've progressed beyond vegetarianism. But the point is that this group was very life-defining for both my mom and myself. And George Harrison had a song and a record and film company called Dark Horse. Name drop. Roll the credits. So I was first introduced to this other culture through both my mother and through George Harrison, but I've always been someone who liked to read about other people's culture and view other people's art. Growing up, my mom always made sure that we went to the library and we were part of different reading book clubs, and she tried to make sure that we always were looking at a variety of different cultures. Like, we long popo, which is kind of like the Chinese version of Little Red Riding Hood. We had all kinds of books and stuff that represented, or at least introduced us to, a myriad of different cultures. So it's not that surprising that once I was getting into the Beatles, and more so into high school, I got very interested in India and East Indian culture. And a lot of that, word of Wednesday, the aesthetic of the art has influenced me. I mean, much like how Victorian art has influenced me. I mean, I love the woodcuts, anything that's really detailed, anything that's really colorful. I've always really been attracted to, I guess that's something that a lot of people do. But I do want to make one thing clear. While this story is inspired by George Harrison and Hinduism, I want to make it very clear that it is not going to have Hindu gods and goddesses. I mean, I have a lot of different things in store for Dark Horse, but I'm certainly not going to just be stealing from another culture's faith. And I mean, yeah, I definitely want the aesthetic to remind people of India, because eventually the story is going to go there. So that is intentional. But even though it's inspired a lot by Indian art, it's and textiles, I should say, because I love the clothing, it's just gorgeous. I want to make it clear that this is also heavily influenced by manga, it's influenced by my own culture, there's a lot of stuff that's going to end up in this story. So you're not just going to be seeing Indian gods and goddesses pop up. I'm not going to do that. But there may be some red herrings in here that are going to make you think that's what I'm going to do. Anyway, that, my friends, will have to wait for another day. The question of the week: what inspires you to create stories, songs, music, maybe a movie, experiences, a book? Let me know down below in the comments. I've already talked about it, and I'm going to continue talking about it, so I'm not going to answer the question this week. thank you to my fantastic patrons. I'm just humbled by your awesomeness. I really appreciate it. Those wanting to give all their hard-earned cash to me can do so by going down to any of the support links down in the description. I can't even say it without laughing, you guys. Oh my god, it's so late. I need to go to bed. Anyway, you could also like, sub, and do the bell thing, and that's groovy too. Next week, I'm probably going to do March's Q&A, but until then, peace and love, fare you well, and keep on truckin'.